This is how you do weddings in India. We're officially in New Delhi. We're gonna go to the New Delhi railway station to buy our tickets for the wedding. Really, just super excited to be back in Delhi. Riding back at this rickshaw just bring back so much memory. We're at the New Delhi railway station and it's hot as fuck. People everywhere. Bayas everywhere. Random group of seat guys just stopped me and want to take a photo. They saw me holding a camera, so they want to be part of it. Punjabi Lions. Just arrived in House Khas village. We used to come here for their, for reggae nights. Yeah, a lot of people here. You can get drinks here, so unlike other places in Delhi. If you see this shot behind me right here, it's the first time I came to India and I took a look at this view and I'm like, man, I'm really in India. So here's the view again. You can see the lake, the pond. I think there's a tomb there.
It was definitely a great feeling to be back in Delhi after so many years. We were still tired from previous day's flight, so after House Khas, we decided to call it a day.
What's going on, guys? It's day two in Delhi. Woke up today, not feeling so fresh. Look like this, with some swim shorts and some shitty loafers. Anyhow, what's on the agenda today? We're gonna go to Qutub Minar.
After Qutub Minar, we met up with our friends and went to the New Delhi Handcraft Museum for a relaxed walk away from the bustling city. We purchased some local art and tried some really high quality South Indian food before heading to India Gate for the evening.
In front of India Gate, it's crazy out here. Literally 1,000 people around this entire area. There's people selling pani puri, selling corn. There's tourists. There's people from north, south, east, west of India. This gate behind me is massive as well. Yeah, it's a crazy, crazy view because people are selling you stuff. People are dressed like funny. People are flying shit. People are selling Lays. Unicorn.
This is our third day in Delhi. Really excited right now because we're heading towards to Old Delhi in Chandigarh. We're being driven by the driver from our place. It's great luxury lifestyle that we're living in now. But unfortunately after this, it's gonna go downhill. It's gonna be backpacking. It's gonna be sweat and tears.
We are walking towards Jama Street. It's just crazy out here. There's kids on school rickshaws, people begging, there's people carrying shit on their heads, there's bayas sleeping on the side of the roads, there's people fixing shoes, kids are going to school, there's Muslims, there's Hindus, there's Sikhs, it's madness here.
Snoop, Digo Double G, the life of the party. Lay back, stay back. I'm in the Maybach. This ain't James Brown, but it's the big payback.
Apparently, it's the largest mosque in India. And it's in the heart of Delhi. It's the most famous one. It was built whatever amount of years ago. So it's, let's say, a spiritual religious spot, which is all over India. It's really cool. The entire Old Delhi area, it's a Muslim populated area. So yeah, Jama Masjid, mashallah. The real reason why we're here today is actually not Jama Masjid. It's that thing right there. So we're gonna attempt
this crazy street.
Yes, that's Chandichak, it's Old Delhi. Street food, bazaar. So that place, real third world. Once you go inside, you're gonna get the gist of it. In Haldi Rum, it's one of the most famous, I think, snack food brand in India. So they have all, stores all across, I think, Delhi. We're gonna have the most famous Indian snack. It's called samosa. I think it has mashed potatoes and these kind of things inside. It's deep fried. And I've been dying to try this out.
How is it?
Amazing. You gotta get the green chutney, dip it in, and you eat it like this.
After finishing our Haldi Rums, we spent the rest of the afternoon exploring more of Old Delhi. Our time in Delhi was truly amazing. And this really made us realize how much we actually missed this great city where we used to live for 1 year. However, it was time for the next part of our journey and head to our friend's wedding in Chandigarh, Punjab. For the next day, we took a 4-hour train ride from Delhi to Chandigarh. It was our fourth day in India and we could not wait to see our friends again after 3.5 years.
Arrive at the hotel Shivalik View in Chandigarh. This is where the wedding is gonna be. We're excited, we're gonna see Vebev, we're gonna see Sean, we're gonna see Ankita, we're gonna see the entire wedding party. Let go.
Quick
interview. What kind of emotion is running through your head right now? Oh my god!
Look!
What does this symbolize?
Yeah. This is supposed to be her name, but the guy did a misspelling. I'm getting married to Ankita instead of Ankita.
So we're inside the restaurant. Apparently it's the number one restaurant in Chandigarh. Everyone knows it. The place is called Daba. Looks like it's pretty famous. Right now it's 4 o'clock in the afternoon. The place is still filled. Police officers behind me with guns. It's all good. Who's eating the Indian salad?
After dinner, we spent the rest of the evening hanging out with old and new friends before settling in for the big event tomorrow.
On the way to the wedding right now, back to the hotel. Veronica's pissed because she couldn't sleep all night last night. I also couldn't sleep that well.
You're lying. You slept like dead.
I had a few beers and I passed out like that. But anyhow, we're on the way to the wedding, so check out the next clip because we're going to be dressed up. So wedding's supposed to start at 9 and then you got to 10. Now it's 11:15. We're here, waiting in the lobby. We're ready to go. The horse is ready. We're all ready.
Let's go! Ready!
Sean. Look at this. All this. And Keaton and Sean. The entrance. The picture.
For the next part of the wedding, the groom's party is supposed to parade with the groom in the middle of the street and bring him to the bride's family and friends. And by far, this was the best part of our trip so far. the parade. The groom unites with the bright side of family and is supposed to make a show and convince the gatekeepers to let him into the wedding officially.
तुझे देखा तो ये जाना सनम प्यार होता है दीवाना सनम तुझे देखा तो ये जाना सनम प्यार होता है दीवाना सनम अब यहां से कहां जाएं हम तेरी बाहों में मर
Pretty much the ceremony part is over, and now everyone's
able to drink.
I don't know how they did that, but they're able to drink. So. Another part of the wedding, not too sure what's going on, but some kind of ceremony going on. We have a priest here, Hindu priest, saying some prayers, magical stuff, man. Indian wedding, one of a kind. Right now is the end of the party. It's been a long day, 9 to 4 o'clock, and they have finished the ceremony. Now they're going to bring Akita back to her place, and Sean's going to break down the door and take her officially.
Woo-hoo!
So,
wait for it.
Congratulations, guys. Congratulations.
Overall, we had a fantastic time at the wedding, and it was something really special. If you would like to see more Coke Boy stories, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below, and see y'all next time.